Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to discuss about zone system or measuring exposure. I'm pretty sure if you shoot film, you probably have the same experience. You went to a beautiful trip and shoot lots of films. Color negative, black and white, and even expensive slide film, expecting for a beautiful photos, of course. When you came back home, sent it to the lab to develop and scan, but what you got is lots of underexposed photos, lots of other overexposed photos, and some of good photos. In photography, there are lots of things to consider before re-releasing shutter. And in film photography, those are more important because you cannot check the result until you develop the film. But if I need to choose, the most important thing while you're shooting film is measuring correct exposure. Some people might say, don't worry about the exposure. Film has an amazing dynamic range. Just overexpose it, it'll be fine. I have a light meter, it's pretty good. I use Sony 16. They are pretty okay and it works most of the time. If that works for you and if you're happy with the result, that's fine. But if you shoot landscape and you're not really confident whenever you measure the exposure most of the time, this video is for you. There are lots of ways to measure the exposure and there is no answer. But when I measure exposure for my film works, I use this Pentax light meter and also the zone system. So let's talk about what's the zone system. Zone system is developed by one of my favorite film photographer as well as the legendary film photographer Ansel Adams. The Ansel Adams explains zone system as the zone system allows us to relate various luminances of subject with gray values from black to white that we visualize to represent each one in the final image. So zone system assign number from 0 through 10 to different brightness value. 0 represent to pure black, 5 middle gray, and 10 pure white. And this value are known as zone, and one zone change is equal to one stop in exposure. So let's have a look at this chart. So as per the chart, zone 0 is represent pure black, which has no information, and 1 is nearly black, and from zone 2, you will be able to see some slight details with texture. And zone 3, you have a good amount of detail and texture. Zone 5 is middle gray, and from 6 to 10 will be same as zone 0 to 4. So it describes zone 5 as middle gray. Middle gray or 80% gray is important to know as it is a universal scale on exposure in photography. When you use light meter like this, this light meter will show the exposure for middle gray. So whenever you measure the exposure with light meter, it will show the setting for middle gray for that specific spot or area. Light meter does not know what kind of photo you're taking. Light meter will just measure the exposure of the spot for middle gray. Let's have a look at this example photo. This photo was taken before the sunrise. So if I measure the exposure on this spot, light meter will show this exposure, which is not what I want. This is too bright and I will lose quite a lot of information on highlight area. So if I measure this point, photo will be quite dark. So I measure this point for my exposure and light meter will show this photo. This looks good and this is a photo that I pre-visualized when I framed the shot. So like this, depends on what kind of scene you imagine, you need to measure the exposure in different point and need to decide where do you want to set your middle gray. Still not clear, right? I'll show you how I measure my exposure in the field. Let's go. One of the good things in film photography or photography in general is that you meet new people who have the same interest and share the experience and knowledge together. I went to one of the lighthouse area and met some new friends over there. all of them was taking films and they had lots of experience and knowledge. And also, it was my first time watching large format camera in person. I almost bought one next day. So anyway, this place usually have a lovely view with colors for sunrise, sunset, and also astro. We didn't have much sunset light on the day, but let's get into the first scene. So this is my first scene. So when I look at the scene, I usually measure the darkest point, brightest point, and main subject, also the other subject that I think important. So in this scene, I measure four different points: darkest point, mid ground, lighthouse, and sky as brightest point. So I use Kodak Trix 400 and I set ISO as 400 and aperture as 8. So light meter shows darkest point shows half second, mid ground as 1/4 of second, and lighthouse 1/15 second, and sky as 1/60 of second. If I set mid ground as zone 5, darkest point will be sitting on zone 4. But sky will be over zone 10 and I won't be able to capture any information on the sky. So if I put lighthouse as zone 5, mid ground will be sitting on zone 3 and sky will be zone 7, which I'll have quite good amount of detail and texture in both shadow and highlight. The darkest point will be sitting on zone 2, but I think there's a quite minimal area and I'll be have some details. So let's have a look. So this is second scene. I had a similar light condition but a bit darker this time. I also measured four different points. Darkest point was 1 second, mid ground was 1/30 of second and 1/60 of second, and sky was 1/125 of second. So if I put mid ground at zone 5, sky will be sitting on zone 6, but darkest point will be zone 1, which is almost black. I want to have a good amount of detail on foreground, so I'm going to place foreground as zone 3, then mid ground will be sitting on zone 6 and 7, and sky will be zone 8. I think I'm happy with that setting. Let's have a look. Here's the next scene, but this time I'll measure the exposure on four different places and you try to decide what setting you are going to use. So this is the exposure. Foreground is 1/8 of second, mid ground is 1/30 and 1/8 of second, and sky is 1/125 of second. Just pause the video and decide what setting you want to use before I show my setting.
A few moments later.
Comment below what setting you have got and compare with my setting later. So this time, I place water on the mid ground at zone 5. So foreground will be sitting on zone 3 and sky will be zone 7, which will contain good amount of details and texture on final result for both shadow and highlight. You have understanding about zone system a little bit better now, but as light was quite flat on the day, I have one more example from another day, which was an hour before the sunset with clear sky. Let's have a look. This kind of scene is quite difficult to decide your exposure if you don't know how to. So I measured darkest point, brightest point, subject 1 and subject 2. But in this scene, I want to make sure I can capture the details and texture from the tree as well, which is quite dark area. If I place darkest place at zone 5 here, it'll be too bright overall. So if I place darkest area at zone 2, which has some detail with texture, subject 1 and 2 will be zone 4 and 6, and sky will be zone 8. Let's have a look. Thank you. Today I shared 4 photos, and what do you think about those exposure? I'm pretty happy with the result, and it came out as I expected. And while I was preparing this episode, I asked lots of people through Instagram or in person how they measure exposure and whether they know about zone system. And I found lots of people guessing the exposure, and also many people get scared to shoot slide film as they're not confident with exposure. If you enjoy, that's fine. Lots of people still take amazing photos. Zone system looks very complicated, but it's very useful and it's even essential for my film photography now. So if you have been struggling with the measuring exposure, try out next time and hope this video can help to learn about zone system. So hope this video was helpful for you, and if you have any question, comment below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.